with your spirit.
Thank you, Father Koop, Father Becker, Reverend Fathers, any honored guests, and my dear brothers. It is indeed always a privilege to reflect on my vocation story in gratitude, for it is a telling of God's perpetual love revealed gradually to a young man, an unworthy sinner, whom God nevertheless calls one of his beloved sons. It is a story of love whispering to me in the depths of my heart, guiding me throughout my life by his gentle promptings. With prayer and discernment, I have realized that my vocation story has two parts, one section that I can remember and another section that I myself cannot recall. As to the section I can remember, I have felt a calling to the priesthood since around third grade. By that time, I had already been serving daily mass at All Saints, my parish, in Lakeville, Minnesota, for around 2 years or so. And through this wonderful opportunity of service of our Lord at mass, I was able to observe the priest closely during the sacred mysteries. I was so fortunate to have such wholly dedicated priests throughout my life at All Saints, beginning with Father Gene Tiffany until fourth grade, the then Father Pache, then Bishop Pache for my middle school years, and now Father Tom Wilson, along with such great parochial vicars as well, such as Father Jonathan Kelly. The seeds of the priesthood were planted in me from such a young age, especially from my parents' prayers and support with me that continuously remain. The development of my vocation to the priesthood within me, by God's initiation and grace, has progressed linearly from my childhood to this very moment. Once I began to feel the call, the Lord helped me to respond with a generous yes, something for which I feel undoubtedly grateful. So this is the part of my vocation story that I can remember. It is now time to transition to the part that I cannot recall by personal memory, my birth story. I was born 11 weeks prematurely on March 1st, 1994. This premature birth was not because of natural circumstances, but by trauma that changed the lives of my parents and me forever. It was a beautiful Tuesday morning on the 1st of March. My parents were driving to Fairview Ridges Hospital in Burnsville, Minnesota, about 20 minutes south of St. Paul here, for the second trimester checkup to see how I was developing inside my mother's womb. The duration of my mother's pregnancy at the time was 29 weeks out of a total 40. My dad, driving a Buick Century sedan, pulled up to the stoplight of County Road 42 at about 8:15 in the morning, being the first car there to prepare to turn left. The light turned green, my dad looked both ways, and started to make the left turn. But suddenly, everything changed. A fully loaded semi-truck, carrying 80,000 pounds of cargo and going 55 miles an hour, came charging through the intersection, blowing the red light, and smashing into our car with so much force that the impact knocked my parents immediately unconscious. When they regained consciousness a while later, my mom began to repeat the phrase over and over, I'm pregnant, and continued this phrase until the arrival of the paramedics. She was thinking more about me than herself, which is a testament to her selfless love for me and for all she meets. My parents' injuries were very severe. My dad sustained a shattered jaw, a crushed pelvis, and a ruptured spleen that was later amputated. My mom also had a ruptured spleen, but the doctors were able to save hers. She also had 3 broken ribs and a collapsed lung. And then there was the question of how I was doing at this point, which was unknown to the paramedics at the time of the accident. The paramedics proceeded to take my father to Regents Hospital in St. Paul and brought my mom and me to Fairview Ridges in Burnsville. Upon arriving at the hospital around 9 o'clock in the morning, the doctors immediately began to monitor my mom and me. And at this point in the morning, I was actually doing fairly well, considering everything that had just transpired. But things began to change drastically around 3:30 in the afternoon. I began to go into distress, which means my heart rate was dropping very quickly, my breathing became much more labored, and although it is difficult to verbalize today, it is indeed true that at that moment I was dying. And upon seeing that I was ebbing away, by God's grace and providence, the doctors chose to take me out right then and there via emergency cesarean section. The duration of the stress was long enough, however, that I came into the world lifeless. The doctors then performed both the necessary breaths and the corresponding cardiac compressions to resuscitate me. And by God's help, they succeeded. After I was more stable then, I was airlifted via helicopter to Minneapolis Children's Hospital, where I stayed for 54 days, literally to grow in the neonatal clinic there. For the time of my birth, I was only 3 pounds, 6.5 ounces. Now at this time, my parents and I are at different hospitals, all three of us. My mom is still in Burnsville, my dad is in St. Paul, and I'm now at Minneapolis. After 2 full weeks, we are finally all reunited together at last, for the first time since my birth, an incredibly emotional and moving experience for all involved. Ultimately, my parents began to tell me of my birth story, indeed our family story, around third grade, which is the time that I began to pray about the priesthood. By learning how fortunate my parents and I are, then and now, not only to be alive, but also not to be physically or mentally handicapped today, I began to appreciate then and continuously at every moment how God had given my life back to me. With both parts of my vocation story considered then, I desire to give my life back to God in service as a priest in humility. As Psalm 103 says, truly, the Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in mercy. In gratitude to the Lord, I humbly sing his praises, in whom we all find our faith, our hope, and our love. Praise be Jesus Christ.
Amen.